Hi, my dear children. Today I'm going to talk about the active voice and the passive voice. This is actually the foundation for the lesson passive voice. First of all, I want to make you understand the difference between active voice and passive voice. For that, let us do the examples. Now look at these sentences. Tom kicked the ball. It is an active voice sentence. The ball was kicked by Tom. The ball was kicked by Tom. That is a passive voice sentence. Right? When you look at these two sentences, you will understand both these sentences are saying the same thing. Even the meaning of these sentences are same. It is just the expression that is different. Okay, now we are going to split the sentences into three parts. They are the agent, the receiver, and the action. Right? Now let me explain the meaning of these three terms. First of all, we take action. In both these sentences, action is kick. That is the basic verb. So, the basic verb kick is the action of the sentence. Then let us move to the agent. Agent is the person or thing that does the action in the sentence. Here, that is Tom. In both these sentences, Tom is the agent. Next, the receiver. Receiver is the person or thing that receives the action. Right? Here it is the ball. In this case, ball receives the kick. So we can say ball is the receiver. Right? Now just see whether you can understand the difference, major difference between active voice and passive voice. What is the major difference between active voice and passive voice? Children, when you look at the active voice sentence, you will see and you will realize the sentence start with the agent. Active voice sentences begin with the agent. See where the receiver is? Receiver is at the end of each active voice sentence. That means, children, in active voice sentence, major focus goes toward the agent. While in passive voice sentence, the major focus goes towards the receiver. So when we look at the passive voice sentence, receiver is at the beginning of the sentence and agent is here at the end. You can understand the agent has been pushed to the end of the sentence. That is the passive voice. And also there is another thing, children. What is that? In passive voice sentences, agent is not that important. If I put a full stop here, just read. The ball was kicked. It has a meaning. It has a sense, children. Even without the agent, we can get the meaning and the sense. Right? So, it is important to keep in mind, agent is not that important in passive voice sentence. Right? And there is another important thing to know. What is that? Look at the verb be. Here, verb be is in past form. That is was. Why is that? We have keep the. Here we have kept the verb be according to the receiver, not according to the agent. In passive voice sentences, we must keep the verb be according to the receiver. Right? The ball was. Ball is singular. As the sentence is past form, we have to take was as verb be. into another example. Right. The teacher marks a book. A teacher marks a book. Right. What is the receiver? So you have to take this. A book is marked by the teacher. A book is. The verb be is he. Why? This is singular and this is present. So you have to take is as the be verb. The book is right. Now look at this sentence. The next sentence. Let us move to sentence number 2. The teacher marked all these books. Right? This is an active voice sentence when we convert into passive voice. All these books. All these books. It is plural. And this is marked in past form. You have to think about them when keep the verb be according to them. All these books were marked by the teacher. Right? Now let us move to the next sentence. The teacher will mark the book. The teacher will mark the book. This is a future sentence. Right? The book will be marked by the teacher. The book will be marked by the teacher. Now can you understand, children? So by looking at the receiver, we have to keep the verb be. Right? Now you know if we want to say or write a sentence in passive voice, it is because we want to focus our attention to the receiver, not to the agent. In passive voice, our main focus goes towards the receiver. And you know the agent is not the key one. Children, there are some instances where we don't want to use the agent. Right? I'll explain you. Our college has been renovated. Our college has been renovated. Where's the agent? Agent is not there. Agent is not visible. Why? It is not that important. When the agent is not important, we don't want to mention that. That is the reason. Right? Now look at the next sentence. My bag was stolen. Right? My bag was stolen. Where's the agent? We don't know the agent. Somebody has taken, stolen my bag. So we don't know the agent. So in a time like that, we don't know to mention the agent, as we don't know who has stolen the bag. Right? Now let us move to the next sentence. The thief was arrested. The thief was arrested. Agent is not there. Why? Agent is obvious here. What is the agent? Everybody knows. The police. So when the agent is obvious, no point of mentioning the agent in the sentence. Right? So these are important things for you to understand. Right? Now let us move to another important part. Right? Do you think, children, we can transfer all the active voice sentences into passive voice? Can we transfer all active voice sentences into passive voice? Answer, no. Why? In this case, the agent-receiver relationship is very important. Right? For that, let us go to the next part. That is about transitive and intransitive verbs. Right? Transitive verb has a direct object to receive the action. Right? So that they can be transformed into passive voice. Right? They sing songs. They sing songs. When you take an example like that, so it has a transitive verb and we can easily convert it to passive voice. Right? So the passive voice is possible with transitive verb. So it is obvious that passive voice is possible with transitive verb. When you look at intransitive verb, an intransitive verb doesn't have a direct object to receive the action. Because of that, we can't transfer that sort of sentences into passive voice. Look at this example. Birds fly in the sky. Birds fly in the sky. This is the agent of the sentence. This is the action. Is this the receiver? This is not the receiver. This part shows where the birds are. So it doesn't have a receiver. So in intransitive verb, this is the problem. As we don't have a receiver, there's no way of transferring them into passive voice. Right? So you should know passive voice is possible only with transitive verbs. Right? Now let us move to ditransitive verbs. What do you mean by that? It is a verb with two objects. It is a verb with two objects. I write an example. My mother gave us nice presents. My mother gave us nice presents. Right? Us. What is us here? That is the immediate object. Convey the person. Right? Nice presents. That is the direct object. Direct object are the things. Right? With the intransitive verb in active voice sentences, we can form two passive voice sentences. How can we? Why? We have two objects. One is indirect object and the other one is direct object. Let us see how it is possible. Right. So first we take this indirect object. Will, verb given. This is past tense. This is plural. So what is the verb to be? We were given nice presents by my mother. Shall I write it for you? Right. What is the other one? We can construct another passive voice sentence using nice presents. Like this. Nice presents were given to us by my mother. Right. Is it clear, children? When we have an active voice sentence with a ditransitive verb, it is possible for us to construct two passive voice sentences. Right? Hope you understood this lesson. Right? Now, let us go to a quick recap of this lesson? What did we learn today? At first, we talk about the difference between active voice and passive voice sentences. Can you remember? Yes, and after that, we realized the meaning of both those sentences were quite same. After that, we would split the sentence into three parts. And there, we learned about the agent, action, and the receiver. After that, we talked about the major difference between active voice and passive voice. There you learned in active voice sentence, major focus goes towards the agent, right? And sentence always begins with the agent and the receiver is at the end of the sentence. Not only that, we learned about the passive voice. Passive voice always begins with the receiver, and what happens with the agent? It goes to the back of the sentence. After that, we learned different instances where we omit the agent, right? And also, we talked about the verb be, how to handle the verb be in passive voice sentences, right? Finally, we talked about transitive verb and intransitive verb. So, we learned the passive voice is possible only with transitive verb. Right? At last, we talked about diatransitive verb. So, there are diatransitive verb. That means, in an active voice sentence with diatransitive verb, we would make two passive voice sentences. This is what we learned today. Hope you understood the lesson, children. Also, I hope you enjoyed the lesson.